The reason why I have made this video is because of the comment by one of my viewers comparing two different CPUs. For this example, I will compare the Intel Core i7-3770K and Intel Xeon E3-1230 version 2. You can follow this procedure to compare any two CPUs. So let's get started. The website called CPUBenchmarks.net, you can find the link in the description. Then we need to come here and select search for CPUs. Then in the search, type the name of the CPU you're looking for and click on find. And then it finds your CPU, and then if you click on it, it gives you its ranking, where it sits, and then if you click again on it, it will give you more details about that CPU. How much power it consumes, how many cores it has, thread, clock speed, what is its class, like it's for desktop. So we got the first CPU selected. Now we want to compare it against another CPU. Then we need to click again on compare. And I can see it's added to the CPU to compare here. And if I select this again, and now if I go here and type the name of the second CPU, it finds it, and then you just select it, and then we have now selected two CPUs to compare. All you need to do is then to click on compare. Here it is, the CPU that I suggested in the previous video, which is called Intel Core i7-3770K, and we are comparing against the one that one of my viewers suggested, which was Intel Xeon E3-1230 version 2. It also gives a price, but again, you need to be very careful with the price, because the viewer said you could get this one for $30. And this one, it says 216. In this website, actually, it says Xeon is more expensive than the i7. But I guess if you buy a second-hand CPU, then it might be a different story. But with regards to the performance, you need to look at CPU mark. The higher the mark, the better the performance. Okay, let's go quickly through these ratings. And you can see here the mark is higher for the i7, so it's a better performance than the CPU value. It says the higher the numbers, the better the mark to the price ratio. Again, i7 scores higher. Then we got a single thread rating, and you can see still i7 higher, and then estimated energy usage cost, and it shows in a year, obviously assuming all these other costs and stuff, it gives you that i7 will consume more energy, but not by a big margin, because you can see the 77 watts against 69 watts. So altogether, they are very similar CPUs. Just one important point I want to add is that Xeon CPUs are designed for server, and i7 CPUs are designed for desktops. You actually can use a server CPU for a desktop, but bear in mind that it's not designed for a desktop. I myself actually run a server CPU for my desktop, and it works brilliantly. So looking at these two, I would say these two are very similar. If you want to get a little bit better quality, I will go with this. And just to have a peace of mind, I will go with a desktop CPU if your application is for desktop.